Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Thanks for checking out the video. Thanks for checking out the channel. Thanks for the support. It's been really kind of amazing. I'm loving doing these things, so I hope you guys are enjoying it too. Today we're looking at, again, more of this I, Russell the Bear Once stuff. IWABLE. You know, whatever the acronym is there. I have the cat's pajamas loaded up. This is the official music video. And yeah, we're going to have some fun with it. So, you ready? Let's get into it. Lots of stuff going on there. First of all, like the vocals seem to be more instrumental in nature rather than like a lyrical delivery system, which is pretty cool. And so I think this is Courtney. I think it's Courtney. It sounds like Courtney. So the vocal lines tend to be a little bit more like, ooh, like whatever it is, and not so much words, which is really cool. Because it really gives the sense that the vocalist is, like, the vocals are an instrument rather than just a vehicle to deliver lyrics, which is cool. I like it. And then the bass, like, did you hear that? And then right at that transition, right at the transition here, like, listen. So it like really struck this balance, that little like bass connector thing there that connected like the verse with the chorus or whatever. Really struck this balance between precision and articulation and like chaotic emotion, which sort of seems to be like the theme for the song itself. One more time. I want to hear it one more time. Right. And so it's like, and there's a very distinct moment of silence, you know, that really is the connective tissue between the two sections of the song. Hold on. God damn. That section was marvelous. We're going to back that up. We're going to back that up just a little bit. I want to hear that again. Hold on though, because where was that? It was like. Okay, so we'll back it up just a little bit. I'll make the point and then we'll listen. What I've noticed about this band specifically that I really like is like every time you think you've got a hold of what they're doing musically, they hit you with something, just a little bit, just like a little bit, just like, you know, little bit of an unexpected jab, you know. And this section specifically got me real good. So take a listen. And I think it was the drums, like the kick drums specifically, that really stood out. And so there's very clearly this buildup, right, as they're moving from one section to another. But it does it in an asymmetrical fashion. You know, it's not like logically kind of like builds up, you know, in a lot of ways that like the Deftones will do. It doesn't really do it like that. It sets up the section to build up into the next one, but it's like, you know, it throws off speed pitches the whole time. So you don't really know what to expect. And just like the little flutter right there, where maybe you would expect either the snare or it was just like the little, like the real quick, and then that was it. And then like the little, just like the random organ fade out. I mean, Look, I really hope that's Courtney, and I'm not just making an ass of myself. So please correct me as to who the singer is. Yeah. Whew. Man, she gets it. Like, I loved in the beginning how there was less emphasis on the lyricism and more emphasis on the musical nature of the vocals. And then as the song progressed, the vocals became more distorted. They started digging into more of like the guttural emotions and bringing that forward, and the whole band like coalesced to support this. I really liked it. I mean, I really liked everything that I've heard from them so far. So that's gonna do it for this one. If you enjoyed the video, please consider subscribing to the channel, hit the like button, share the video, do all that stuff, and I'm gonna get out of here, and we'll catch you in the next one. Peace.